Shaquille O'Neal shuts down Tiger King backlash. Tiger King, Murder, Mayhem, and Madness is the new Netflix binge-worthy docuseries that we cannot stop talking about. And if you haven't watched, you need to do so right now. Spoilers ahead! Shaq makes a brief cameo in the documentary, seen visiting Joe Exotic's Oklahoma Zoo in 2014. Fans were quick to speak out against the former NBA player after the series revealed that Joe ended up in prison for animal abuse and initiating a murder-for-hire plot against fellow Big Cat owner Carol Baskin. Shaq clarified his connection to Joe Exotic on his The Big Podcast with Shaq, sharing,
"I forgot what year it was. Anyway, Dallas was playing OKC. So instead of flying back and forth, me and Alex, we get on the Shaq bus. So on the way, we see a sign that says Tiger Sanctuary. So we go in there, and it's a beautiful place. And the character that was there was Exotic Joe. And we're there, and, you know, I drop some donation for the Tigers' foods and all that. We take pictures with Tigers. We went back a couple times. Then we go back another time, and we found out that he's involved with all this stuff. And then I stopped going, but I had no idea all that stuff was going on."
Shaq also goes on to explain his love and admiration for big cats.
"People that know me, they know I'm righteous. I don't harm tigers. I love tigers. I love white tigers. And do I put donations to these zoos to help these tigers out? I do a lot of time. Do I own tigers personally at my house? No, but I love tigers. And listen, people are going to make their own opinions, but again, I was just a visitor. I met this guy, not my friend, don't know him, never had any business dealings with him, and I had no idea any of that stuff was going on."
The news comes not long after Tiger King directors Eric Good and Rebecca Chaiklin responded to backlash following comments from Carol Baskin. In a lengthy statement on her website, Carol accuses the series of incorrectly portraying her side of the story, from the mysterious disappearance of her former husband to the daily function of her zoo. She also writes that they were told it would be the big cat version of the documentary Blackfish, which went on to expose SeaWorld of animal abuse. Good responded to her comments in an interview with the LA Times, sharing in part, "Carol talked about her personal life, her childhood, abuse from her first and second husband, the disappearance of her ex, Don Lewis. It's not a Blackfish because of the things she spoke about. She certainly wasn't coerced. The other thing I would say about all these people is that there was a lack of intellectual curiosity to really go and understand or even see these animals in the wild." Good went on to say, "The lack of education, frankly, was really interesting, how they had built their own little utopias and really were only interested in that world and the rules they had created."